Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Right now, Filming Me is the brand new FM Duo in 8K 60 frames per second. That is 4K per eye. That's what you're looking at right now. And next to it, we have the Z Cam K2Pro. It's the highest end professional VR180 camera right now in the market. And on top of it, we have the Insta360 EVO, just for comparison. And you can see the chart right here. And today, I want to show you the image quality difference between the brand new FM Duo and the Z Cam K2Pro and see which is the best professional VR180 camera for your production. So you are ready? Let's dive right in.
Here, we have FM Duo in 8K, 60 frames per second, capturing our model. Not Kitty here, our model is Kimchi, my Shiba Inu. He really wants to hold the color chart, as you see right here. Where Kitty is standing right now, it is about 3 feet 1 meter away from the camera. Now, she is pushing the chart really close. You should be close-eyed if you are looking at the color chart. Now, both Kimchi and Kitty are really breaking into your personal comfort bubble. Depending on what kind of content you are making, you don't want to have close-up like this for a long time. Now, we are testing the side-to-side stereo 3D for you. FM Duo, you clearly see lens flare on the side, which you will not see later in K2 or K1 with the Izuka lens. Now, Kitty is doing a distance test in 3D. In FM Duo, we capture full 8K, 4K per eyes in 60 frames per second, or 12K, 6K per eyes in 30 frames per second. So the resolution is so good, you can see through the windows in the distance of my yard. Now, Kitty is doing a jumping jack, while Kimchi is trying to steal the color chart again. Having a 60 frames per second motion is very important in VR headset.
No! No! No!
Now, we have the exact same video shot on the Z Cam K2 Pro in 5.7K in 60 frames per second. The settings are exactly the same as FM Duo, both in 10-bit H.265. K2 Pro can capture Z RAW or ProRes 422 HQ, but it will fill up a 256GB CF card in like 18 minutes, which is not really practical in most of my production. FM Duo can shoot in RAW and they are working on ProRes as well. Just need Apple to approve them to use ProRes. In H.265 10-bit, FM Duo bitrate is about 1700 Mbps per second, which is why it can look so much better when we have ProRes recording. Back to K2 Pro, we did not do an exact dynamic range test, but FM Duo looks to have a better dynamic range thanks to Panasonic MM34450 full frame image sensors, the same full frame sensor of Canon R5. K2 Pro with the Izuka MX200 lens had less to no chromatic aberration at all at the edge of the lenses. Here is FM Duo again. Just look at the edge of the windows. So, in conclusion, K2 Pro has a better lens than FM Duo, less chromatic aberration and no lens flare. In terms of operation, Izuka aperture range has clicks so you know when it is exactly f5.6 and when it is f8. FM Duo lens does not have that. Izuka has an aperture from f2.8 to f11, but FM Duo has f3.5 to f16, so K2 Pro will be better in low light, and FM Duo will be better in direct sunlight outdoor scenario. Both cameras are extremely good in low light. K2 Pro can go to ISO 2500 and is second native ISO. FM Duo use dual gain ISO just like Canon R5, so it is also very no noise in ISO 2500. Okay, now take a look at K1 Pro. K1 Pro max resolution is also in 5.7K, but its frame rate maxed out in 30 frames per second. In close-up, K1 is not bad, but around 6 feet away, the camera starts to get blurry. Look at the poster on Kitty's left. Now compare it with K2 Pro and FM Duo. You see, sensor resolution is kinda a big deal in VR180 camera. More resolution is definitely better looking. But the biggest issue is not resolution, it is frame rate. 30 frames per second in VR just won't cut it in 2021. Take a look at the jumping jack session here. It will give you a headache with this fast motion. Now you are watching Insta360 EVO in 5.7K in 30 frames per second. It is even softer than K1 Pro and has the same motion blur issue. But looking at the quality, it is very close to K1 Pro, so I don't suggest to update for now. There will be a consumer level VR180 camera coming out very soon. I know you are so sick of waiting, but it is worth the wait if you don't want to spend a lot on a professional level VR180 camera. FM Duo has a pretty good dynamic range when shooting outdoors. Here we have FM Duo in aperture FA shooting in Rec 709 color space using highlight priority mode. FM Duo has a special mode, highlight priority or shadows priority, to set auto exposure. The sky is in a very strange red color today, and the FM Duo captures the color pretty accurately. By the way, the reason why the sky looks red is probably because of fire in California. We suffer from fire and earthquake in Los Angeles. Kimchi and I probably should not play outside, sucking in all those smoke. So the dynamic range can get even better. Here's FM Duo in Sony S2. FM Duo decided to use Sony color space instead of their own, making color grading a lot easier. You can use your favorite Sony S2 LUT here, which save you lots of time. Here is the result. If you do not want to color grade, but still want great dynamic range, I would suggest using sRGB instead of the default Rec 709. FM Duo also support HDR color space to future-proof their camera in case HDR is coming to VR headset.
So thank you for watching. Just to make sure, I set the FM Duo right now in ISO 23,000 and 1/60, and we are in nighttime, so it's kind of an extreme low light scenario. Same as the ZCAM. ZCAM is the native ISO 25,000, also in 1/60. So you can compare side by side in the same ISO distance, and we can see that noise and image quality between the FM Duo and the ZCAM K2 Pro. In the next 2D in-depth review video of the FM Duo, we will get hands-on and I will lead you through how to operate the camera, what to watch out for, and how to build your entire professional setup so you can go out there filming confident. This is a really great camera, but again, there's a lot of things that you need to watch out for, and I will go into detail of that in-depth 2D review and compare it side by side with, again, the ZCAM K2 Pro and the Insta360 EVO. So if you are new on this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell right here and give me a thumb up if you can. And I will see you next time, or see you in VR.